compliance of Chapter 231, Public Law 1975, entitled Open Public Meetings Act. Adequate notice of this meeting has been provided as specified in the Act. Proper notice of this public meeting was provided in the notice of May 9th, 2011. Said notice was posted at the entrance of the Board of Education offices, mailed to the Nutley Sun, the Star Ledger, the North Jersey Borough News, and the Nutley Journal. Mailed to the Nutley Township Clerk, advertised in the Nutley Sun on May 19th, 2011. Posted on the district website. This is an official meeting. Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hold the roll, please.
Here.
Approval of minutes. I have a motion to approve the minutes as distributed.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Discussion. All those in favor?
Aye.
Minutes are approved as distributed. Correspondence.
We do not have it.
Superintendent.
Thank you, Mr. President. As the board knows, last Thursday we suffered a tragic loss of one of our students, Daniel Warren. I had not met Danielle in my short time here, but I have learned a great deal about her over the past few days. She was a tremendous student. She was a leader in the building, in our community. She was a star in our culinary arts program, and a trusted employee at a number of places in town. When an event like this occurs, along with grief, we are left with questions, and questions that unfortunately many times go unanswered. As a district, I can report that we did act immediately. We acted to support our students as well as our faculty and staff. We've also reached out to Danielle's family since Thursday and done our best to support the community as a whole in any way that we can. We've leveraged every resource that was available to us and have done, as I said, I think everything we possibly could to support them. Our leadership team was exemplary. I have to thank them. From the high school and across the district. Our counselors and our team of special service providers were phenomenal. They've been there for every single student. They haven't stopped in 5 days. They've worked with parents, we've worked with community members, and just through it all have just been fantastic. So a heartfelt thank you for me personally goes out to them. They've certainly gone above and beyond. From early Thursday morning until about an hour ago out in the rain, all of our staff have tirelessly given to ensure the health and safety of our community. We've communicated again using all media in an attempt to reach every single person and disseminate accurate information as it was appropriate and timely. I do want to thank the police, the fire, emergency medical services providers, as well as our staff that act as liaisons with those, Mr. Ferrara, Mr. Nicolette. The level of cooperation that's happened, I think the board recognized through our communications, just been, I would think, exactly what we needed. I am still in contact with the police and also with Daniel's family, and each of them has asked me to convey one clear and specific message at this time. There is no evidence that this tragedy was caused by or linked to any harassment, intimidation, or bullying. Out of respect to the family and the information that's come out, I can't really say more. But what we can say is that as of this time, again, I'll say again, that fact that this is not linked in any way, shape, or form to harassment, intimidation, or bullying. Our students, our children are dramatically influenced not only by the loss, but also our reaction as adults to it. We have to be responsible for our behavior. We teach our kids with what we do and what we say and how we say it. We need to make sure that the information that we as adults are giving out is accurate and has been substantiated. And is given in the best possible way in the best situation. We need to make sure that when the information is shared, we have the right professionals on hand to help young people with the questions that they're going to have. And I think that we've done our best to make sure that we do that. Through the process, we've worked with the Tragic Loss Coalition, reached out to them immediately, as well as a number of state organizations and student groups. What this event has brought to light, in their words, is that our district, Nutley Public Schools, is doing all that it can to support and teach our students. We've received praise for the programs that we have in place, as well as for our response to this unfortunate incident. We encourage everyone to help us to continue to help. If you see something, say something. It's a message we've been saying to the students. I cannot say that strenuously enough. Sharing information allows us to provide help where, when, and how it is needed. It is especially critical that we teach our students this. They must know it's better to reach out for help while help is able to be given. Case in point, we were alerted by a student of a comment on the internet this weekend. She had the insight and the wherewithal to inform us, and because of that, we were able to identify and provide help to the student in need, even when we were closed. So please encourage people. If you see something, say something. That said, please understand that we're in an age where technology makes it almost impossible to monitor everything. We are committed to doing everything we possibly can and ask for your help as we serve our community. As for formal business, there was an outstanding complaint against the board regarding trash disposal. I've met with the complainant, and the complaint has been dropped. Will most likely be refiled against the trash company. In the interim, though, Ms. Shamans and I continue to communicate with the company regarding our expectation that town ordinance always be followed. Following up the presentation of superintendent's goals and the conversations that have exploded since, I'm happy to present for the board's approval tonight a partnership with Performance Matters and an assessment warehousing analysis tool. The tool will not only aid our conversations regarding data on external assessments such as state tests like the HESPA and the ASP, but national tests as well. It also will allow our teachers to mine the data that they choose to produce and inform decisions from the classroom level all the way up to the district level. As well, goal number two, I wanted to let everyone know we're in the final stages of preparation for strategic planning. I've been in contact with Dr. Lavera a number of times over the past 2 weeks. We've outlined a timeline for work that will allow us to complete the goals as planned and involve each of the stakeholder groups in the most efficient and effective way possible. Moving to facilities. We have already attained one quote for repair of Spring Garden gym floor. We have classic rescheduled to come in and meet with Mr. Riga. We will have a timeline to communicate to you, the board, a week from today. Budget preparations have been ongoing at the building level. Set to receive initial plans from our principals by this Wednesday. At this point, we'll begin the central office phase, where we will be right-sizing those proposals and communicating back down so that we can make one clear and reasonable budget presentation to the board's finance committee. Finally, and I think on the highest note, I continue to meet with administrators and faculty regarding teaching and learning. We continue to have meaningful conversations, and as we progress, we'll start to have public presentations on the work that we see in front of us and the work that we're doing as we move forward. We have challenging, exciting conversations ahead of us. Excited to say that. Based on our response to recent specific challenges, I know that this board, this district, and certainly this community are prepared to meet the challenges, so I look forward to meeting them.
Thank you, Mr. Leslie. I'd like to commend you and the staff for handling the very difficult situation this past week. Secretary's report.
It was all covered by the superintendent.
Next on the agenda is a presentation by Dr. Commissioner Scarpelli.
Good evening, everybody. I'm here on behalf of the Scarpelli Civic Association. Just a little history on the Scarpelli Civic Association and make a short presentation. But, the Scarpelli Civic Association has been around for over 30 years. It was started by my grandfather, and I guess Mr. Scalera and Mr. Spizzato were familiar with. A great guy. And that was continued by my father. After being elected, I was encouraged to reorganize the Scarpelli Civic Association. The organization in the past was more social, although it did charity work. We thought we'd organize around a specific area, and we chose autism awareness as that the focus of our organization. It's very apropos, since the longtime president of the Scarpelli Civic Association, Mr. Scavone, has family who has autism, and also Mr. Brower, who's the current president, has a daughter with autism. So we thought that was very apropos. We started with three goals. Our first goal was to give a scholarship to a high school senior who's in a special education program who's going on to post-secondary education. We raised enough money to actually give two scholarships this past June, $500 for those who are going on. Our second goal was to support the autism program in the schools, and that's what we'll be doing tonight. Our third goal, we hope we'll be able to accomplish very soon, is to start a varsity sport within the high school for those in special education. Tonight, I'm pleased to present 6 Apple iTouches, 7 Apple iPads, Otterbox cases for them. Those are for the autistic program. We have a EdMart Level 1 and 2 Deluxe Combo Reading Series that are for the self-contained classrooms. They're presently being used in the classroom, but they share them. This will be able to provide more individual instruction. And we also have 2 Caliphone Spirit stereo listening centers so that the students can learn without being distracted. We also should have been delivered today a 25,000 BTU air conditioning to Radcliffe School for the autistic classroom. And tonight we also have a HP 8500 printer and scanner. This was all derived from a meeting with the teachers at the end of last year. We continue to talk with the superintendent and Gina Volani to have a formal way of us receiving requests. We will continue to raise money. We will continue to support this program. I'm very happy to be able to do this for the autistic children in this district. Thank you.
At this point, since there were some changes to the agenda for tonight, this is not something I'm making a habit of, but for this particular occasion, we're going to go into closed executive session for about 15 minutes so that we can discuss those changes with respect to personnel and a contract. Whereas the Board of Education will be discussing matters exempt from public discussion pursuant to NJSA 10:4-12, now therefore be it resolved that the Board of Education recess to close executive session at this time to discuss personnel and contractual matters relative to the assessment management system. Be it further resolved that the results of the discussion made public by inclusion on the agenda of a subsequent meeting of the Board of Education or when the reasons for discussing such matters in closed session no longer exist. So move. We have a second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
We can move quickly to executive so we'll be back.
So you want me to put
call the roll, please.
Here. Ms. Flynn?
Here.
Dr. Reed?
Here.
Mr. Rogers?
Here.
Mrs. Russo?
Here.
Mr. Scalera?
Here.
Mrs. Pizzotto?
Here.
Mr. Cota?
Here. Committee reports. First, I'd like to make a comment that, as everyone knows, the full board met with the commissioners to discuss shared services. Subcommittees were formed. I'd report that those subcommittees have been meeting in preparation for a meeting on December 5th. We'll get together again. Any other committee reports? Finance?
On November 15th, the Finance Committee met. Myself and Trustee Spizzato met with Ms. Siemens to talk about a few agenda topics. We discussed in general terms the budget status and the development and the process going forward. We talked about some of the negotiations, and we talked about flexible spending account proposals that were reviewed in light of changes in law and issues we need to address. We discussed some of the construction payments and change orders that were up for review. We had some questions and requests for clarification. Operational reviews are underway by the district and the administration, and we will be anticipating additional information to be presented to the Finance Committee at the next meeting, at our next meeting. We discussed that the CUSAC review process is going forward, and that our audit report for the district is being completed, and a presentation will be made to the Finance Committee and then to the full board in December.
Thank you. Administration.
Thank you, Mr. Butcher. I'm giving this for Mr. Kaczynski. We had a tremendous meeting on November 3rd. One of the topics was to discuss solar. It was a great meeting, and also in following up to our meeting with the commissioners, but Commissioner Tucci was there talking about possibility of VPAs, energy sharing, audits that he's had done. Tremendous meeting. He really wants to work forward and work with us between the township and the district, and the more solar we bring to the project, the better it is for all. We had a consultant met with us there. We will be developing an RFQ. We decided since, and we'll be adopting the procurement committee's start the adoption tonight, but as per the new document, we'll draw up an RFQ to go out for a consultant to assist us and the township in preparing an RFP for solar so that we're following all the new guidelines. The committee also recommended, which is on tonight, the adoption of the ad hoc procurement committee, which is also on our agenda here this evening. We reviewed some of the hiring process, the RFP policy review, and we'll be moving forward next month with an RFP for the board attorney, which I think is posted now, and also the athletic position was discussed, and Strauss Esme has the policy manual review and updates at no cost, and we'll be proceeding with the review of all policies after we hear back from Strauss Esme. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Any other committee reports?
Yes, Mr. Kushka. On November 15th, the academic committee met to discuss the various technology issues impacting the district. Superintendent Lasvik provided an extremely thorough overview regarding two particular products regarding our student information systems, along with a computer-based teacher and student assessment system. I know a lot of research has been conducted by Ms. Milani, Mr. Lasvik, in terms of identifying a product that would suit or best suit the needs of the district. An RFP has been prepared, and I know that's going to be going out shortly in regards to identifying or at least securing a student information system. On a related issue, the district is also narrowing its search for a director of technology. So at least once we secure this individual or identify this particular individual, he or she will be better able to address these particular needs in terms of integrating this SIS system with the broader district plans. As described in our meeting by Superintendent Lasvik, the student information system will have all the bells and whistles that we've been seeking as a district and as a community, that being true online report cards, attendance information, a parent portal, which will hopefully give us the opportunity as parents to access homework assignments for our children, progress reports, and in addition, regarding a special module that will address the special services reporting requirements, which are pretty heavy for the district on the state as well as the federal levels. And then I'd just also like to thank and commend Superintendent Lasvik for informing us this evening that we have secured Performance Matters as our computer-based teacher evaluation and student assessment system. This will give us the opportunity to incorporate and correlate student data with teacher evaluation information. It's important to note that this is not a punitive endeavor directed towards our teachers. If anything, it's an opportunity for growth. So as a committee member as well as a board member, we're extremely excited and supportive of this endeavor. And again, it will provide us with the opportunity to run common assessments and leverage these data to improve teaching as well as learning. Last but not least, we were also given insight regarding a program of study that's taking place at the high school, and the academic committee will be apprised of this report come, I think, latter December, early January. But this is an opportunity for the school district to embark upon a comprehensive needs assessment at the high school in which all programs of study will be examined, recommendations will be made for improvement. Again, our AP requirements, grading system, course offerings, class size, it all runs under that gamut. So we look forward to that report come the latter part of December, early January. So thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Reed. hearing of citizens. We now come to the portion of our meeting where we allow members of the public to address the board. In this session, we allow questions or comments on only the resolutions addressed in tonight's agenda. Our board regulations allow 20 minutes for these communications. Each person shall be limited to 3 minutes, and we ask you to try to stay within this requirement. Speakers may speak more than once only after all others wishing to speak on a topic have been heard. All statements will be directed to me as the chairperson, and no one may address board members individually. Please be reminded that if your statement is too lengthy, personally directed, abusive, obscene, irrelevant, or redundant, your participation may be terminated. Please remember to always state your name and address each and every time you address the board. Will the first person please step forward?
Good evening, Mr. President. Alan Thomas, 108 McKinley Street. Mr. President, I have a question regarding finance resolution number 12. This is approval of a partial payment to GPC Inc. Who is GPC Inc.?
They're a general contracting service that the district had hired to coordinate multiple contracts.
Has the situation with the Spring Garden gym floor been resolved?
In what way?
Decided who's going to pay the repair?
Yes.
And who's that?
Right now, based on the tests, a company made by the name of Sunnyfield, which was responsible for the holes in the roof, the installation of certain piping on the rooftop unit, which that was the actual cause of the leak, and therefore the damage to the floor. We have separate monies that are being held for the
Mr. President, I inquire because I'd like to know what provision of our contract with GPC allows us to retain $10,000 until the
intent is to retain that money until it, so that it's leveraged, making sure that the gym floor is repaired.
I understand the purpose. I'm wondering what is the provision of the contract with GPC that allows us to do that?
I'll have to get back to you on that.
Okay. And I ask that because I'm wondering why only $10,000 is being retained. It seems to me that your contract probably has a provision that a payment can be withheld until satisfactory delivery of services is completed. At least a final payment or some other payments. And just to see an arbitrary number like $10,000 makes me wonder whether we are essentially amending the contract with GPC to only withhold $10,000 when in fact we are entitled to withhold more. I don't know that's the case because I have to see the contract, but I do wonder about that.
We'll have to get back in there.
Okay. Well, I would appreciate if the board would not approve any further payments to GPC until that issue is resolved. The contract needs to be examined to see what the board's rights are in terms of withholding payments to our general contractor until we are fully satisfied with their performance. And to pick an arbitrary amount is simply going against what the board's rights are under the contract. Maybe against what the board's rights are under the contract. And to do so without that knowledge, I think, is imprudent for the board's vast.
But it might be an optimum amount to make sure that the work is just proceeding in a timely fashion.
Yes, and that would be a subjective decision. What we're talking about is the contractual rights of the Board of Education. Until that's examined, okay. I don't think you should approve this resolution.
Point is made.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Anyone else wishing to be heard? If not, close this.
Mr. President, finance resolution number 14.
Yes.
Approval of a change order for the HVAC upgrades at Nutley High School. This is a change order to install sheetrock on the existing exterior wall.
Yes.
Sheetrock on the exterior wall?
There was air conditioners embedded in those walls where it's close enough. With the central air, we don't need those units.
Exterior wall meaning the outer wall of the school building?
Outer wall on the inside.
Well, I see exterior, that tells me
no, it's the exterior wall of the building, sheetrock goes on the inside.
Okay.
It's fine.
And it's per the owner's request? I mean, per the board?
You had an option of leaving the units in the wall or taking them out.
No, but you're the owner?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. If there's no other question, I have just one more.
Anyone else? Go ahead, Mr. Thomas.
Thank you, Mr. President. I just wish to congratulate the board for putting resolution administrative resolution number 3, the procurement policy, on the agenda tonight. Needless to say, this is a proud moment for the board. I wish you'd gone further with it, as especially you know, you and I have discussed. But this is a great step forward. It's so important that for the Board of Education to maintain its credibility with taxpayers and with the state and with all other stakeholders, that proper procedures be followed. And as Dr. Reed pointed out in his committee report at the last, I think it was the last meeting, the previous meeting, okay, we are now spending lots of money on attorneys because proper procedures that were in place by law back then were simply not followed. And when I say proper procedures, I mean not just the letter of the law, but the spirit of the law as well. And I will bring up the TriTech situation. This was a contract that was approved by the board, okay, based on a recommendation by somebody else, by one of their trusted officials, that this did not have, this contract did not have to go out to public bid.
Okay. Mr. Thomas, I thank you for your appreciation for the resolution. I think that the TriTech matter is still in their litigation and we do not want to discuss it.
I don't expect you to discuss it, Mr. Kutcher, but I would like to finish my comment if I may.
So it's short.
Almost done before you interrupted me. That is a contract that should have sent red flags among all Board of Education members, because it necessarily involved the board paying a contractor millions of dollars in fees. Okay? That should have raised red flags for all board members as to, can we really approve such a contract without going out to public bidding for it? Because you relied on somebody's recommendation, not this board, of course, but the board at the time relied on recommendations. They didn't. They didn't ask that simple question. And I encourage this board to ask such questions.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Anyone else? Not, I close this portion of the meeting. Dr. Reed, you move academic resolution.
Yes, Mr. President. I'd like to move academic resolution number 1, as stated.
Discussions. Call the roll, please.
Mrs. Nancheck Martin?
Yes.
Ms. Flynn?
Yes.
Dr. Reed?
Yes.
Mr. Rogers?
Yes.
Mrs. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Scalera?
Yes.
Mr. Sposato?
Yes.
Mr. Kupka?
Yes. Mr. Scalera, the administrative resolutions 1 through 3.
Sure.
I make a motion to move administration 1 through 3, please.
Second. Discussion. Call the roll, please.
Mrs. Danchek Martin?
Yes.
Ms. Flynn?
Yes.
Dr. Reed?
Yes.
Mr. Rogers?
Yes.
Mrs. Russo?
Yes.
Mr. Scalera?
Yes.
Mr. Sposato?
Yes.
Mr. Kupka?
Yes. Mr. Sposato, would you move finance resolutions 1 through 14, please?
Yes. I move finance resolutions 1 to 14 as written.
We have a second.
Second.
Discussion. Ms. Flynn.
Mr. President, I would make a motion to table resolution, finance resolution number 13. There's been a number of questions I've had. Ms. Stevens did get back to our comprehensive finance meeting, and Ms. Stevens did get back to the contract. We got additional information, but it still raises more questions than answers. So I would just like to make a motion to table it.
Second.
There's a second. Yeah. Discussion. Call the roll on the motion to table.
Mrs. Danchek Martin?
Yes.
Ms. Flynn?
Yes.
Dr. Reed?
Yes.
Mr. Rogers?
I just have one question before I vote. Will we run into any problems without paying this bill? Is there a time constraint?
This is only a change order, right?
Change order. Is there any?
This isn't a payment. This is a change order.
All right, so there's no legal issues if we don't proceed?
I'm not voting until we get more information. That's all.
Right, it's a change order, Steve. It's not a payment, so it's.
All right, then I'll vote the affirmative, yes.
Mrs. Russo?
Yes.
Mrs. Valero?
Yes.
Mrs. Pizzotto?
Yes.
Mr. Cooper?
Yes.
Do you want to do that all?
No, put 13 on the table.
All of 13.
Okay. Any other discussion? Call the roll, please.
Oh, excuse me, Mr. President. Just, I'll be abstaining, just abstaining on number 14.
Okay. Call the roll, please.
Mrs. Stanchek Martin?
Yes.
Ms. Flynn?
Yes.
Dr. Reed?
Yes.
Mr. Rogers?
Yes, on all but communication bills on the resolution number 3.
Mrs. Russo?
Yes.
Mrs. Valero?
Yes, on everything I stand up for.
Mrs. Pizzotto?
Yes.
Mr. Cooper?
Yes. Mr. Scalera, move personnel resolutions 1 through 13.
Mr. President, I move personnel resolutions 1 through 13.
Second.
Discussion. Call the roll, please.
You want to read 13?
Yeah, we'll maybe.
Number
13, read it.
13
is entirely right.
So, I'll help you.
Whereas it is with a sense of deep sorrow and regret that the Nutley Board of Education records the death of Mrs. Florence Gebbie on November 2nd, 2011. And whereas Mrs. Gebbie was employed in September 1978 as a teacher in Nutley Public Schools and had a distinguished educational career until her retirement in July 2005. And whereas Mrs. Gebbie won the admiration and respect of her fellow teachers and the friendship of pupils who came under the influence of our understanding and capable teaching. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Board of Education of the Township of Nutley extends deepest sympathy to the members of her family, and be it further resolved that this resolution be made part of the minutes of this meeting and a copy sent to the members of her family.
Thank you. Hold the roll, please.
Mrs. Stanchek Martin?
Yes.
Ms. Flynn?
Yes.
Dr. Reed?
Yes.
Mr. Rogers?
Yes.
Mrs. Russo?
Yes.
Mrs. Valero?
Yes.
Mrs. Pizzotto?
Yes.
Mr. Cooper?
Yes. Hearing of citizens. In this session, we allow questions or comments on all school-related matters. Our regulations allow 30 minutes for these communications. Again, each person shall be limited to 3 minutes, and we ask you to try to stay within this requirement. As stated earlier, all statements will be directed to me as chairperson, and no one may address the board members individually. Please be reminded that if your statement is too lengthy, personal directed, abusive, obscene, or irrelevant, or redundant, your participation may be terminated. Please remember to always state your name and address each and every time you address the board. The first person wishing to be heard, please step forward.
Good evening, everybody. Sharon Baza, 68 Ray Street, Nutley, New Jersey. I do have some packets that I would like the board to be presented with. I don't know if you want me to just hand them to you guys. Is that okay?
Yes. Maybe drop them. Yeah, we'll pass them around.
They're all in order.
Yeah,
they're all. Everybody's name is in chronological order. Good evening again, Superintendent Lasovic and the Board of Education members. Since the last time I attended your meeting, I have continued to move forward with great effort in my endeavor to institute a school uniform dress code for the Township of Nutley. I had the pleasure of meeting with our superintendent to discuss the issues at hand, and his input showed me that his primary concern is the children of our school system. I also had the opportunity to meet with two of your high school students who work on the Northern Gray newspaper. I thought the article they presented captured my point of view, and I was very impressed with the voluntary poll they took at the high school, which stated that 29% of the students polled wanted uniforms. That would be 3 out of every 10 children. Mind you, it wasn't the entire school. It was a small percentage. So that's a pretty high number for that. Lastly, I started a petition signing, which brought in approximately 500 signatures. There's about 300 included in your packet. They're signatures of residents and school-age parents who are in favor of seeing this change in Nutley. And I've been contacted by so many parents over the past few weeks who have joined that force. A few weeks ago, I was given the opportunity to gather information from a superintendent that encouraged a school dress code uniform in his district. After reviewing everything, I have taken the liberty to put together a package for each board member to review. Included in this package is copies of the petitions that have been signed, some of them, along with the basics of how to structure a dress code uniform within our own district. As I mentioned earlier, the school paper did a voluntary survey. That would be the next item on the agenda, allowing parents to be surveyed. I have included a sample document which includes the questions that could be addressed. Due to budget restraints, mailing may be very costly, so may I suggest that you email them to each parent, just as we receive all the other information from the school via email. Another concern was the cost for some families. Although through previous research, it shows that the cost of dress code uniforms today are much less expensive than trendy clothing. We currently have a total of 3,955 students enrolled in all of our schools. The Nutley High School has 1,293, John Walker Middle has 631, Lincoln 469, Radcliffe 324, Spring Garden 367, Washington 402, and Yanacol 469. With close to 4,000 students, 439 are currently receiving aid for reduced or free lunch, which would most likely qualify them for some sort of assistance with the school dress uniform. If indeed the school board had to incorporate assisting some of these families, the cost, giving each child $100, it would be less than $50,000 into the budget. I was also exposed to the fact that this might go to the taxpayers. Well, if it goes to the taxpayers, and you give each child, 500 children, $100 each, it comes down to $5.67 per household per year, because we send out 8,817 tax properties in this township. I cannot stress how important it is, I feel, about making this change. If this gets put onto the back burner, you as a board are making the decision to not allow the students of all children who attend our public schools to be part of the decision making. Do the survey. Let's see how our parents feel about making the change. If indeed our parents of today's students want this, the next step would be to form committees, including the board, teachers, and parents. And this can be accomplished and be put into place by the 2012 September school year, as long as we all do our part. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else wishing to be heard?
I am 153 Lakeside Drive. First, I would love to thank Commissioner Scarpelli for donating those items to the autism program. For those of you who are not aware, kids on the spectrum really benefit from the iPad and the iTouch. They're valuable teaching tools. It's not just a game. Additionally, I just want to let everybody know that I have been working directly with Art Monaco in creating the CPAC, the Parent Advisory Group for Special Ed Parents. It's also going to be inclusive of parents of non-disabled students, educators, community members, with the hopes of really, creating a coalition and working with our district to create a more inclusive environment for children with special needs. Lastly, on a completely separate note, Chartwell, the new system, is a disaster, which I'm sure is no surprise to you guys. In essence, at the elementary level, what they have to do is pay in advance, which I'm totally in agreement with, but it's kind of hard to get the younger ones to order their food 2 weeks in advance, and whoever's sick, or when you're in fifth and sixth grade, you can go out to lunch. You know, if they want to do that on the fly, you lose the money that you give to Chartwell. You know, do they give it back? Are they just pocketing it, It would be nice, of course, to be online would be ideal, but that's a stretch. But even if we could just, like, you know, have something in place where we can pay in advance and just let the kids choose on a daily basis or something along those lines, so there is a method for them to order the food and for the parents to receive funds in the event that their kid can't make it to school. You know, I can't tell you how many times my daughter went out to eat, and I have no idea when that $2.65 went, but, you know, you add that up over time, and it does add up to a nice chunk of change. So that's it. Thank you.
Anyone else wishing to be heard? Not opposed this portion of the meeting?
And Freddie gets to business.
No, he was away for business.
He's getting excited.
Old business. Any old business? Yes.
On the issue of shared services and the meeting we had with the Board of Commissioners, this is something that we've talked about for quite some time, and it's long overdue, and I'm really happy to see this moving forward. One of the requests that I made with the Radcliffe PTO, I'm a rep at that school, and I make this request of you all here today in the public. If you have any ideas that would help make government more efficient and help save tax dollars, please don't hesitate to share that with one of us or a commissioner. You know, sometimes the best ideas come from the people that are being affected by the decisions we make. So don't hesitate. No idea is too small. We're living in tough times, challenging times, as the superintendent said. So please get in touch with one of us or a commissioner or the superintendent if you have an idea. And maybe we can, you know, move it forward, and it may save us some tax dollars and make government a little bit more efficient than it is now. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, sir.
Chairman, if I could get on all
business.
Just on the same subject, you know, and I want to thank the president and the superintendent for putting it together, but we had a tremendous meeting with the Board of Commissioners, if anybody had followed that up. And, you know, I've moved to town many years, and many times people have talked about getting together, setting agendas, setting times. We have committees put together. We have future meetings times set. We have a date set. Those are great things for the township, and I want to thank everyone for the board and the commissioners. It was a great meeting, and I think it's going to be a huge success. And Mr. Kutcher, thank you for your setting up as the president.
Thank you.
And yeah, old business. Yeah, I know we discussed this chart well before. And I thought we asked, I know I did, to have them either come and meet with us, make a presentation, which I'm sure has to be done in public because we can't do it in private. Because I got a lot of questions. You know, I'm hearing from a lot of people about a lot of issues and what we just heard before. We need to address ASAP.
Yeah. I have one question, maybe
for
Mr. Kutcher. I know you have to close dates because of the early snowstorm. People were asking questions about what should they do in light of that, because they paid for lunch, and should they get a credit? And some people are saying just write a credit on the form. I don't know if that's the right answer. Like, should they need credit?
I don't know the answer. I mean, they don't lose their money.
No one is leaving their money. Most parents will write that there's a credit due because of those days. But something was also should have gone home in the newsletters from each of the building principals. And I'll follow up to make sure that they continue to put that in their newsletters home to the parents.
Or maybe they can even put
that's
it on
the process.
Yeah, maybe on their future forms that they send home to pre-order, maybe they should just note, maybe put like a credit, like maybe they missed or absent. I don't know.
Any other old business? New business? Mr. Sklar.
Thank you, Mr. President. I went to prep you before this, but Mr. Viviano, everybody called him Mr. Viv, passed away. Longtime teacher, football coach here in Nutley, passed away this week. Was here when I was in school, Tommy, I don't know who else, but great guy. If we just have a quick moment of silence for him, I'd appreciate it. Thank you, Mr. President.
Any other new business?
Hi. Quick question. I promised Lincoln School PTO that I would bring this up. Can anyone give me history as to why we have the half day before Thanksgiving? The reason for that is what people are traveling, it's an anticipation of.
It's probably something that's been going on, and it's a pretty common practice in business, I believe. I know, when I was working, we'd always leave early the day before major holidays, you know, Christmas, Thanksgiving.
Many of us do not have a half day the day before Thanksgiving, and it makes it very inconvenient. Fortunately, we have the extended day program that still remains open. But is that the ongoing reason because of it's always been done that way?
Well, I think we approved that, though, when we approved the space back in those days. I think we should ask that. I think we should ask before we
vote on the schedule every year.
Before we approve it again, I think we should.
We get a half day before Christmas Eve.
We're in development of the calendar right now. I know in the past it's been developed certain ways. We're going to make sure that it's more of a collaborative process this time, so we can take some feedback on it. I will say that the first time I've heard that question, but we'll make a note of it.
With the month of November being an interesting month school year wise, there's a lot of questions about, you know, the half days during. It's just a disjointed month in so many ways, and you know, that's something we need to talk about as a board going forward. And I think we just threw a wrench in it with the snow days.
That might also be something in negotiations with contracts.
We said seriously.
For days off?
This is a half day.
Only half a day now?
Well, I mean, the calendar has to, they have to have 180 days of school.
Right.
So however you do that, it's the half days that are more flexible.
Which calendar is a full day? Okay.
Any other new business?
I just have to report on the Washington School PTO meeting. It was a very good meeting. I just wanted to report back, because I think it should be highlighted, the fact that the Washington School PTO, they're paying for clubs that we could not otherwise authorize due to budget constraints. And I think that says a lot about that PTO, is to really step in. And one particular thing that we hold near and dear as public officials here is the student council, that they decided to fund that. So I just wanted to bring that to the board's attention.
Good job, Ed. Good job.
Any other new business? I'll close that. Whereas the Board of Education will be discussing matters exempt from public discussion pursuant to NJSA 10:4-12. Now therefore be it resolved that the Board of Education recess closed executive session at this time to discuss student matters. Be it further resolved that the results of the discussion will be made public by inclusion on the agenda of subsequent meeting of the Board of Education or when the reasons for discussing such matters in closed session no longer exist. I so move.
Second.
Those in favor?
Aye.
Proceed to closed session.